Hello, Pixel Pioneers. Get your hard hats on, because today we're doing a deep dive into the architectural foundation of all 3D models, the vertices, edges, and faces. Understanding these can be the difference between building a sandcastle or building a skyscraper in Maya. So before we get swept into the nitty-gritty of the vertices, edges, and faces, let's set the stage by talking about the two primary modes you'll be using in Maya, the object mode and the component mode. To set the stage, let's introduce it with a simple 3D object. I will move on with a torus. The object mode is like, think about it like a wide angle lens. It allows you to interact with your entire 3D object as a whole. So you want to move your torus, you want to rotate your torus, or you want to scale your torus. The object mode is your go-to. Think of it as dealing with the big picture. So after understanding the object mode as a big picture tool, let's delve into the stars of the component universe: vertices, edges, and faces. So vertices, let me zoom in a bit. Vertices are the corners of our 3D shapes, the points where the edges meet. Edges are like the highways that connect these different vertices. They define the structure and the wireframe of the object. And faces? Well, faces are the flat surfaces bounded by these edges. They are the visible skin of your 3D object. So you have the corner, the vertices, you have the highways, the edges, and you have the skin, the faces. Now you might be itching to get your hands on these vertices, edges, and faces. Patient, young Padawan. We'll go into the how-to in the upcoming chapters, where we will delve into each of these components in more detail. So first up, vertices. These are the junction points where the edges meet. Think of them as the cornerstones of your 3D construction. So you can select them by going over the object, right-clicking, and going into the vertex mode. So let's get these vertices moving. You can select them all individually with the left mouse button. You see, I'm just hovering over the vertices and left click on my mouse to select them all individually. Let me go into the move tool with W on my keyboard, and I can now start to morph the object, or better, the vertice. You can hold down shift key to select more than one vertice. And here we are, now I have created some sort of a crown. So, but what if you don't want to select your vertices individually, but you would like to select them as an entire row? Okay, let me show it to you. You click on the first vertice, you hold down shift, going along the edge, going to your last vertice and double click it. And you see, you have now selected all vertices in between your first and your last vertice. Let me just repeat it once more. I'm clicking on the first vertice. I hold down shift, following the edge, and double click on the last vertice I would like to have. So scaling is just another superpower the vertices have. You can just hit R on your keyboard. The scale tool pops up, and you can now start to scale your selected vertices to a new dimension. You could just scale it uniformly. You can squeeze it or stretch it to your desire. You can do the same with the rotate tool. You just hit E on your keyboard, and you can now start to move your selected vertices based on the axis you have, or free from by clicking in between and just moving it to your desire. So now let's talk about the edges. The edges are those sleek lines that serve as the connections between the vertices. They're like the steel beams in a building, providing the framework upon which everything else is built. So getting into the edge mode is a snap. Just right click on the object and from the contextual menu, pick edge. You'll see now they're becoming highlighted and ready for action. Moving edges alters the geometry, so creating new angles and new shapes. It's like we're not just the architects, but we're also the construction workers of this 3D world at the same time. So open up the Move tool by hitting W on your keyboard, select an edge, and now you can morph your entire object by morphing that single line. So same principle, you can hold shift and select more than one edge. You can also click on the first edge, hold down shift, double click on the last edge, and you have selected all edges in between the first and the last one. You want to take it to the next level? Sure, we can do that. You don't have to select the edges one by one. So you can just select or double click one edge and it automatically creates the entire edge flow. Let me repeat. So just like your friends, the vertices, edges can also get a good stretch. So hitting R on your keyboard brings up the scale tool, allowing you to enlarge or shrink the selected angles. Yep, you can also rotate. Hitting E on your keyboard, and now you can make the edges swing like dancing salsa. Look at this. So, last but definitely not least, we've got faces, the flat surfaces between the edges. If the vertices are the DNA and the edges are the skeleton, faces are the skin of your 3D model. When it comes to rendering, these are the stars of the show. To start working with faces, right-click on your object and choose the face option from the menu. Once you're in the face mode, you'll notice that the faces will highlight in red when hover over them. This is Maya's way of telling you they are ready to be selected and manipulated. So once selected, you can move them around. Just hit W to move your selected face into different positions. But wait, faces like to go big or to go home. Scale them by pressing R on your keyboard. This can help you to shape your object in more complex ways. You can also rotate them, just like a spinning top. Press E on your keyboard to activate the rotating tool. If you change your mind about a face and want it gone, just hit delete. It's like the eraser on a pencil, but for 3D models. But remember, once it's gone, it's gone. So in that case, I have now the possibility to look inside the torus because I have deleted the face. So you need to select multiple faces, similar to the vertices and the edges. Hold down shift and select the different faces. But that's not all. You want to select a whole row of faces? Click the first one, hold down shift and double click the last one. And now you selected all faces in between your first and your last selection. One more thing. Faces can be more than just flat. The extrude function lets you grow new geometry. Head to the edit menu, the edit mesh menu, and select extrude. And now you can provide more depth to your selected faces by having introduced a complete new set of faces. Let's continue. Edit mesh, extrude. All right, Pixel Pioneers, we have reached the end of our CGI journey today. We have delved into the nitty-gritty details of Autodesk Maya's building blocks, components, vertices, edges, and faces. These aren't just abstract terms or random dots and lines. They're the DNA of your 3D model. They're how spheres become planets, how squares become buildings, and how a couple of stray edges can evolve into a complex masterpiece. So, look at what you have accomplished today. You have taken your very first steps into the larger world, one where you holding the building blocks of reality, at least virtual kinds, in your very own hands. With these foundational skills, who knows what worlds you will create tomorrow or the day after. And this is just the beginning. You have to trust me, so you won't want to miss what is coming next. If you have found value in this video and you'd like to continue this exciting journey with me, go ahead, hit that like button, subscribe, and don't forget to ring that notification bell. Doing this will make you an honorary Pixel Pioneer and, let's face it, the coolest club in the CG galaxy, right? With today's knowledge, you are now equipped to explore, experiment, and excel. So, until next time, keep pushing those boundaries, keep breaking those boundaries, and above all, keep creating. The digital canvas is wide open and it's waiting for you to make your mark.